Hi, my name is Janine Dorothy. I'm with the Maryland Department of Agriculture Mosquito Control Section. And today we're going to do a yard inspection to show you what you'll be doing if you have to do Zika response in some of these communities. First of all, you're going to come to the front of the yard. Just do a sort of a pan around the house. The front yards usually are not nearly as bad as the backyards. However, what you can see here, if you look at the gutter here, there are a lot of plants growing in this gutter. So you know that water can collect in that gutter. That's one of the things that you'd have to tell the homeowner to fix, because you can't do anything about that. And then if you come over here, this little thing has some soil in it, but if you get a lot of rain, you could have water on top of that soil, and that could hold water. You get little pockets of water in here, and down under these frogs and the turtle, there are, it looks like there's been water in there, so that has been a problem area. So what we're going to do is go head to the side yard and then to the back, and that's usually where you'll find most of the problem areas in a house. As soon as I go down the side yard, there's a collection of pots and containers here. This one is a flower pot turned upside down, and you can see there's water in each of these little sections here, and that could breed. So we're just going to turn that over and empty that out, put it so that it won't hold water. Then we've got this container right here, which has a mosquito pupa in it right now. Dump that water out. And then this flower pot saucer, which also has some mosquitoes in it right now. That can be turned upside down. You don't want to turn this completely upside down or it'll hold water in there. So just make sure it's upright, or make sure the homeowner gets rid of it. And then there's water in this plastic bag. You want to dump that out and have them throw that in the trash. Look at the neighbor's house, and I always look at the neighbor's house when I'm doing a yard inspection. We have a corrugated drain pipe right here. This stuff will hold water in each one of those corrugations, and if I pulled it off and dumped it, there's probably water in it now because we've had a lot of rain. So this stuff, if it's connected directly to the downspout and there's not a lot of gaps, what they need to do is just screen this end so that mosquitoes can't fly up in there and lay eggs. Where a bamboo shoot has broken off, like this one, there's a little bit of water in there, and that's their native habitat. So they're very used to breeding in very, very small areas. There's not much you can do about a bamboo stand. Okay, we get down here, we've got some other junk that has some water in it. Watering can, and there are mosquitoes in there. I'll turn that thing upside down. This, you can actually see the larvae in these two things. This is a pot that should be upside down. You see all those wiggly things in there? Those are the mosquito larvae. So that water looks like it's been in there a while because it has a lot of debris in it. So we're going to turn that upside down. This one also has larvae in it. Several different sizes of larvae in there. So that one goes upside down. Okay, and right across the path here, there's some more garden implements that we're going to check. Plastic container, which probably shouldn't be out here. This has some really small larvae in it, as well as a few big ones. So you have four different stages or sizes of the mosquito larvae, and they start out very, very tiny. So there's several in there. We're going to dump those. Again, they should get rid of these things if they're not using them. This has a mosquito pupa in it, and this has a few larvae in there. So these can be stored upside down for now, but the homeowner really ought to get rid of them. This should not be out here at all unless it has a plant in it. It's full of water, so we're just going to dump that out. And then over here, there's water in this, and there's water in the bottom of that. There's just a little bit, but tiger mosquitoes can use that much water. So these, we'll just have to tell the homeowner. I'll dump this one out for now, but the homeowners need to fix that so that it doesn't hold water. Okay, we've got a couple more containers here, and there's some through the fence at the neighbor's house. So starting with the ones through the fence, I don't know if you can get a good shot of those, but if you look down in these containers, They're both pots. They do have holes drilled in the bottom, but there's water in there around where the holes are. The holes are not drilled exactly in the corners, so they're going to hold water after rains. They've got a little yard cart over there, and they're okay. This deck has a roof on it, so this is not going to get rained on. But if they have an open deck like this one, you have to check. The one over here is an open deck. You have to check things underneath that to make sure that water hasn't come through and is puddling in some of the things over there. Okay, but getting back to these, we have a cup that actually has mosquito larvae in it, and an old pet dish that's been left upside down, and that has water in it as well. So again, homeowner needs to store these things inside. But for right now, they won't collect water and breed. Okay, first of all, this bucket, you can see there's a little bit of water in all of these sections with the bucket turned upside down. That's enough water to breed tiger mosquitoes. There's a pond here. If there are fish in this pond, that's something you'd have to ask the homeowner. If there are fish in this pond, they'll eat the mosquito larvae. If there are no fish, it could be full of larvae. Okay. This pool looks like they do have an aerator, but it's not on. If the water were circulating, it might not be breeding mosquitoes. But back behind these plant things, that's going to block any circulation of the water. So this could be a problem. This would have to be checked. You'd have to go around and ask the neighbor for permission to go in their yard as well. And the tire right now doesn't have any water in it. But tires are a major breeding area. It's how the tiger mosquito got here in the first place. And they can breed several hundred larvae if there's water in that tire. Okay, let's continue on. Okay, over here on the little patio, I see some culprits. This, I think, is a kid's sand tray. And the water should be dumped out of here. I don't see any larvae in it right now. It's probably fairly new water, but that should be dumped. And then any of these containers on the table, some of them, they don't have water in them right now, but all of them could hold water. And then we've got a bucket, which may or may not be something that the kids are playing with water in, but this water's been in there a while and needs to be dumped. If you're going to have something like this, you want to dump the water out once a week and put fresh water in it. Okay, the tarp over this wood pile is actually really good. They've arranged it so that there's not any puddles on top of it. If you look, there's not any puddles. It drapes down. It doesn't hang on the ground and cause problems. So this one's really good. Most tarps don't look like this. Okay, but we go over a little farther, and there's a tarp that was probably in use and isn't now. And this one's full of water. It has mosquito larvae in all this water. I don't know if you can see them in there. There are larvae in there in all these puddles. So this, if they're not using it, should be drained out and then stored inside. You see how much water is in the tarp. So that should be stored inside. And then we've got this, it looks like a kid's slide. And there's larvae in all of these little sections on the bottom of this slide. So I'm going to dump that. The other problem with this, with a lot of kids' toys, you see these holes in here? If water gets inside here, mosquitoes have an easy time going in those holes. And then they can breed inside the actual toy. It doesn't have to be water that's outside. So again, it needs to be stored inside. The gutter here looks like the gutter on the front of the porch. It's got maple seedlings growing out of it. I don't see any standing water, but if you've got things blocking the gutter like this, you will often have standing water in there. And if you're looking at nothing else, you should look behind someone's shed, because that's where they put everything they don't want anymore. So we see a tarp has water on it. Some of these little plant holders. This one has holes drilled in it, which is a good thing. That's not going to hold much water. These do not, and they have water in a lot of the little crevices. So if they're stored that way, they might still hold a little bit of water underneath. Better to store them inside if they're not using them. And then this tarp has puddles on it. Here, here, there, and here. Oh look, when I drained it out, it's going straight into the unused kids' pool down there. So some of the water from here was running off into this pool. So this pool, not in use, and it has a lot of water. You could get 100 or so mosquitoes out of that water. So again, dump it, have the people store it inside if they're not using it. Okay, let's head up the other side. Okay, we talked about that corrugated drain pipe up there. This is a buried piece, and just because it's buried doesn't mean it won't hold water. You can see the water in there. There's probably mosquito larvae in there. This piece goes all the way back up, probably all the way up to the house. I can't tell where it's coming from, but buried pipe is even more of a problem because it's very, very hard. Once these ends get broken, it's very hard to screen that. So the person might have to treat that. I see another pond up ahead. We're gonna check that out. Okay. I'm seeing something moving in this pond. I don't know if there's fish. If there are fish, there will not be mosquito larvae because the fish will eat them all. But you have to check on these. Ask the homeowner to stock it with fish if they haven't already. Otherwise, there's really no way to keep the mosquitoes out. Let's head under the deck. This is an open deck, so you can see light through these decks, there's water getting through. And you can see in this cart, it's a little dark in here, but it has had water. So the water's coming down from above when it rains and filling up this cart. And things like this bucket with rocks, if it's gotten rainwater in it, it's very hard to check and see if there's water in there. If they're only going to keep rocks in it, they should drill holes in the bottom. You can drill holes in the bottom of anything you don't need to hold water in. This is very near the edge, so it has probably gotten rained in, and it's going to have water in those sections around the lid as well. Recycle bins, I can't turn this one over, but recycle bins will breed no matter how you put them. If they're sat like this and they don't have a hole drilled in the very corner down here, then water will collect in the corner. If you flip them over, water will collect in all of these little sections and in the hand well, although they do have a hole drilled in the hand well here. This could be a problem if there's not holes drilled in the bottom, they're keeping firewood in there. Drill holes in the bottom if it's under a place where it can get water in it. Okay, we've got a baby swing here. And if you look at this tray that was on the baby swing, it's not on the swing. And you see the dirt here? That means water has collected there in the past, so that could be a problem area. They've drilled holes in here, I'd drill another hole right there. And then they've drilled holes in the bottom of the swing here, or it came like that, but water collects in this little corner. So there's always something. Let's see what else. This is another one of those toys that you could have problems because you have a hole in the wheel. If it's sitting upright and it gets water in there, if you hear sloshing when you move it, there could be mosquitoes breeding actually inside the tire. And then there's a little bit of water collected in these holes here, and there will be water down in there as well if it rains. So this one, I don't know if it's better upright or better. It's probably better upright, but again, if you're not using it, store it inside. And I think that's about all I can see in this yard. So that's what you're doing for a yard inspection. You look for anything that might hold a little bit of water. You also check the neighbor's yards while you're in someone else's yard. It's very handy because now we know we need to go talk to the neighbor with the pool and ask them to either aerate it or put some kind of insecticide in there to prevent breeding.